everyone. It's me, Katie Beth, again. And today we're making spaghetti squash. So I've never actually made a spaghetti squash before, so I don't know which method is going to be more efficient or come out better between my Instant Pot and my microwave. So let's get cooking and see how they turn out. So I did end up buying two different size squashes because that's what they had. So the bigger one I'm going to put in my microwave, it does have a sticker with directions on how to microwave cook it for 12 minutes. So as the directions say, I'm just gonna stab it a whole bunch to let it air out like a potato. And then I'm going to do the same thing with the smaller one, which I will be putting in the Instant Pot. So first things first, I'm starting with the microwave one. I'm just putting it on a normal plate and setting it for 12 minutes, as the directions said. And now I'm just gonna let it cook in there, keeping an eye on it to make sure it doesn't explode, because I'm not sure that's not what's gonna happen. So, well, that one's in the microwave. I'm going to move over to the Instant Pot and put my smaller squash in the Instant Pot with about a cup of water. Seal that on, make sure the air part is sealed. And I did Google how long to put it in for, and Google told me 7 minutes on high. So I put it on for 7 minutes, and now I need to wait for it to turn on and warm up probably for about 20 minutes. So this is probably going to be the definite longer wait to cook a squash. So it's been about 10 minutes already, and the squash has not exploded, so that's pretty exciting. After the timer went off, I decided to check it right away just to see how it felt. It's real hot, a little squishy. I'm gonna leave it in there to cool down for a while. And while I was cooking these squashes, I also baked some meatballs for the boyfriend, not me. I don't eat ground beef. And this is the marinara sauce I got at Aldi. It's the one that I found that had the lowest amount of sugar. This one has about totaling 4 grams with zero added sugar, versus just a regular can of tomato sauce had more. At first glance, it looks like it's less because the measurement is a quarter cup instead of the half a cup, but it has 3 grams for half the amount. So the Aldi one is what I went with. Plus it's already seasoned, so I don't have to worry about seasoning it more. So for the two of us, I warmed up about half a jar of the tomato sauce, marinara sauce. And back to the Instant Pot. It's finally starting to cool down after about a half an hour. So I got my cutting board out and all these different seasonings. I didn't know exactly what I was going to need to season the squash. So this is the one from the microwave. And I'm cutting it open this way because this is the way I've seen it cut open. But it was really hot even after cooling down a little bit in the microwave. So I had to use a little mitten. And I'm squishing it. It kind of feels like a rubber baby doll's head, like the hollow part when you squish in on it. But it's still really hot, so it makes it hard to cut this squishy thing. Woo! So now I'm gonna need to scoop out those seeds from the inside. So I got a spoon and this whip topping container to put my trash seeds in. And it's kind of a little difficult to dig them out, especially since everything's still so hot. You can see the steam just coming off of these still. So I'm finding that using these tongs is really the easiest way to get the seeds out. And I just wanted to show you these seeds. There are actual seeds in there, just so you don't think I'm throwing away random stuff, which I am, but there's actual seeds, kind of like pumpkin seeds. It would be a totally different texture that you wouldn't be expecting in spaghetti, so I went ahead and took those out. And now I'm just shredding it, kind of like pulled pork, I guess. just shredding it with a fork. Oh, now this is the way the strands go. Because I cut it this way, it's the short strands. Whereas if I cut it the other way, it would be more round strands. So on the next one, I think I'm going to cut it the other way. I don't know if that made any sense. But now I'm just going to shred this all up and then put it into the container I'm saving here on the side. And then do the same thing to the other side of the squash. And as you can see, it pretty much all comes out. So you're not wasting too much at all. So this is what the whole squash ended up looking like. And back to the Instant Pot. I did let it slowly release for 20 minutes so it didn't do that big gush of steam coming out. Just got the normal steam. And you can see the water's still in there. And I'm just using the tongs to get it out of there because it is real hot. Now, learning from the other one, instead of going long ways, I'm going to cut it in half this way so I'll get the longer spaghetti strands. So all the way around will be the strands. I'm just getting out the gunky insides. The smaller squash seems to have more seeds. I don't know if that's because it's a younger squash or with its size or what to do with that, I don't know. It is coming out a lot easier. Again, I don't know if it's because of the size or because it cooked longer in the Instant Pot, possibly. Everything is real squishy. Squishier than the other one was. So it might be just because it cooked for longer. And this is the total amount from the little squash versus the big squash. Quite a difference, actually. And I'm gonna do a little taste test. See how they taste. And they taste pretty much the same. So here's the meal I made for myself. Just marinara sauce, cheese, and the pasta and some garlic. And then for Jason, I made the same thing, just with some meatballs in it. Overall, we both really liked this form of pasta. So as far as spaghetti squash goes, I'd say this experiment was a success. Highly recommended. Thanks for watching, everyone. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and have a great rest of your night.